Right, that's well said. Let's talk about your encounter 2012 and 2010. Yeah, I know the talk of town in Lagos then, that assassins were after you. You were attacked by some assassins and they tried to kill you, they tried to take off your life, you know, they tried to stop you. So tell us, were you aware or do you know those who sent them after you? Matter of fact, just tell us about this encounter with assassins and who you think was after you at that point.
Yeah, everything was letterman open to me. Even before they came to us, to carry on that dirty job, the Lord ministered to me that some group of people around you have paid people to assassinate you, to kill you. It was revealed clear to me. For that time, I asked the prayer warriors. Sister Agnes was the head of the prayer warrior. I told her at that time, the Lord told me that some people are coming to shoot me. Please mobilize all the prayer warriors to begin to pray for me. And what was my offense? That time we have not come to Zion Grand here. We are somewhere in desert. So different group of pastors are coming to there. You know, that place is very big place. Then if you come, you can put your canopy with your group. So different men of God, different ministers. And then I was preaching this gospel I know. You know, I tell you, I like to preach the truth. There was this day I preached that it's not good for any man of God to charge money to pray for people. The Bible says that freely you receive, freely you shall give. Then what this nonsense that when you want to go to somebody's village to pray for him as a man of God, you ask the person to bring 200,000 or 500,000, and now the person will begin to price. Why not I pay 150? When has gospel become
commodity?
I'm telling you, my brother. So I preach about this, and I preach about that you must not tell your followers that they must sow seed before God bless them. You must not tell them they must pay tithe before God bless them. There is nothing bad about tithing. Nothing bad about that. But it shouldn't be our main priority today when we went on the stage. Malachi 3:10. That is the only quotation that many men of God know. You must not tell people they must pay money before you lay hand on them. You must not tell people that bottle of olive oil of 200 naira, you said is a highly anointed one and you are going to sell it 25,000. That this thing is bringing shame and disgrace to Christianity. You must not be telling your followers that 500,000, I'm coming to your home. This is wrong. If aeroplane for his pastor or his priest, it's okay. But he should not charge it. He's not buying and selling. That was my offense. So many men of God around me say that after that message that their members left them because their eyes open. You know, the gospel we are preaching is to open people's eyes.
Good news.
It's a good news. So when I preach that message, so many followers of some pastors left them. So pastor said that the only thing we can do to this guy is to get him out of the way. Because that time we'll be praying here, you see some of them manifesting in their group. The anointing is raw. I did not pray to get it. I was born and started. That is why you cannot encounter me with a good mind and your life remained the same. It's not possible.
Exactly.
So they paid some guys to finish Ebukobi.
Okay.
Now, before they came, the Lord told me they are going to come. And after the prayers, the Lord says, I'm going to deliver you. Fear not. Because when you read the book of Isaiah 54:17, it says, no weapon that fashioned against you shall prosper. Verse 15, it says, they shall surely gather. But if they gather the of God, they shall scatter. Romans 8:31, if God be for you, who can be against you? For Romans 8:1, there is no condemnation unto those who are in Christ Jesus. 1 John 4:4, little children, fear not your God, for greater is he who is in you than of the world. And if you read the book of Romans 8:37, it says, in all this we are more than conquerors.
Yes, sir.
So, now, before they came, the message came, I prayed about it. We fasted as if there is no tomorrow. I noticed we are praying. Four boys were rolling on the ground. Uncontrollable rolling. I don't even know that their gun was with them in their pocket. As they were rolling, the Holy Ghost arrested them. This God that we are serving is powerful.
Wow.
And not that after the arrest, after the program, you see them confessing. They came to meet me the next day. Fire, fire, please help me. Man of God, we came. This is the gun. We came to show you. Look at the picture that the pastors gave us. It's not their picture. They gave us, do you recognize us? We are the four people that were really uncontrollable. We don't know what happened to us. We have been killing people. That day, you are the second assignment. And that desert was the best place to assassinate you. But what happened? We entered there. We could not know what happened to us. We started going on the ground. I was looking and I was sharing text.
That's the power of the Holy Ghost.
Honestly. And I say, who sent you to come and kill me? They say, it's pastors that you preach that it's not good for them to be charging money. And that was the offense.
Wow.
There was a priest, a Catholic priest, then in Orile, which I called. I have to pray for them. I have forgiven you, but stop killing people. Stop doing this kind of business. If they have given you money, go and return it back to them. So most of those pastors that sent them, one letter came. I don't want to mention his name because, you know, we're online. One of them came and confessed that since that time he has not had peace. After that, more than another attack again. So it has not been easy. But I come to know that one with God is majority. You know, the best thing to hold very well is God. When you are really connected to God, there is no need to fear anything. You don't need to be afraid. And that is why I cannot sleep every day without examining myself. That if there is anything I'm afraid of, it's God. I don't just want to offend God because I have no native doctor. I don't belong to any group. Only what I know is my Bible and my God. And he has been saving me, delivering me. There are so many challenges. 2017, everybody will know. My name was everywhere. I don't want to go to that side now. But God has delivered me. So that is my experience about the assassin. Not once, not twice.